Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to go over rows and columns in Microsoft Excel.
Also, we will have some additional training options for you at the end of this video, so stick around for that.
So if I open up a workbook inside Excel, I can see these letters across the top. Each letter represents a column in Microsoft Excel. So if I highlight B, I can see that I'm highlighting the entire column right here. D, F, etc. So in Excel, there are 16,384 columns. Now the numbers over here on the left represent the rows in Microsoft Excel. I have row 2, row 4, row 6, row 8, etc. And Excel has 1,048,576 rows in every spreadsheet.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
So let's say I am in my spreadsheet and I want to get some information about a particular cell. I'm going to take D2 for my example here. And let's just go up to the home ribbon and I'm going to color D2 in black. And then let's say I'm somewhere else in my spreadsheet and I want to know what the row is for D2. So if I type equals and I can type in the function row with a left parenthesis, and I can see that the argument I'm being asked for is a reference. So if I click on D2 and hit enter, I can see that I'm being returned with a 2 because my reference of D2 is actually row 2. So if I go in here and instead of saying D2, I say D100 and hit enter, you can probably guess that I'm going to be returned with the value of 100. So the column function is very similar. If I type equals column with a left parenthesis, and I click on D2 again, and I hit enter, I'm now being returned with a 4 instead of a D. And that's because D is my 1, 2, 3, 4th column over. So the row and the column functions will return a number and not a letter. So if I click back in here and let's say I change D to DZ and I hit enter, I will be returned with the number 130. So in order to get to this 130, I have gone through the alphabet 5 times. First of all, for my regular A to Z. But after I get to Z, you can see that my columns are going to start with AA, and then BA, CA, DA, and then all the way through DZ. So if I count that, 1 for the columns that have no letter in front of it, 2 for AA, 3 for BA, 4 for CA, and 5 for DA. If I go over here and I type equals the 26 letters of the alphabet times 5, you can see that DZ is in fact in the 130th place. So we actually have a blog entry that goes into this topic a little bit more in depth. I'm going to include a link to that topic below in the description on YouTube, so you can go there if you would like to have more of an explanation of the row and column functions. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.